Hey there guys, I'm Jesse Crowe, the traveling scientist, here in Los Angeles in America. Today I'm going to be looking around Santa Monica Pier and the Venice Beach area. I also want to talk about the science behind marijuana and how it's just been legalized here in California.
California, here we come.
So this is crazy. I actually feel like I'm walking through GTA, the video game here. I'm walking along Venice Beach and the game was just modeled exactly on this place. Like everything is identical. I'm just looking around waiting for some crazy guy to jump out with a gun and start murdering people or just driving down this pathway and hitting everyone. Hopefully that doesn't happen though. Another thing that happens on GTA, you know when you just walk around you can hear people just saying stupid stuff out loud? That actually happens here. Like, I'm just walking around and I didn't just hear people saying the most ridiculous things. My toes hurt. Somebody said that before. That was a bit weird. Is the big meal big? That's another one that I heard before. Or past a girl before that was just saying, I don't like my new phone. Say something intelligent or at least lower your voice a bit. Come on. Anyway, GTA aside, this place is actually really cool. I flew in yesterday, and one of the first things I noticed, or the first things I was told about, is that marijuana is actually legal in California now. That means you can buy it, and you can smoke it. You can't smoke it in public, obviously, and you can only buy it in certain places, but I went to a shop yesterday called Hollyweed, which, hilarious name, sells a bunch of cannabis products, and seems really legit. Now, weed or marijuana or cannabis contains THC. Now, THC stands for tender hugs and cuddles, because that's what it feels like when you get it. Not really. THC stands for tetrahydrocannabinol, and has these relaxing effects. So it can relax your gut, which sort of makes you a bit more hungry, relaxes your head, relaxes your brain, just kind of calms you down and chills you out. So the fact that it's illegal in so many places around the world is a little bit bizarre. I mean, alcohol is legal in most places around the world, and alcohol, when you think about it, is actually a lot more dangerous and deadly than marijuana. It causes alcohol poisoning, you know, liver failure, diseases, causes a lot more car crashes. Alcohol is really dangerous, and I think a lot of people abuse it. Because marijuana doesn't really kill anyone. Marijuana doesn't really do any bad things. There's some old research that suggests that marijuana use can reduce your intelligence and increase the likelihood of mental disorders. Those studies weren't undertaken very well, and I think that more scientific research needs to be done on marijuana to find out how it impacts on our mental and physical health. I don't really use marijuana, but the point of this video is just open the discussion about the fact that it's becoming legal in more places around the world. And I think now that marijuana is being legalized in a lot of places, I think more research really needs to be done to confirm the fact that it really doesn't have that many negative health effects. Or maybe that it does, I don't know. Like, that's still to be determined once and for all. How do you guys feel about that? Do you think marijuana should be legalized in more places around the world? Or do you think it should be completely banned and illegal? Let me know in the comment section down below, and subscribe for more traveling science every week as I travel around America for the next few months. I'm gonna be making some pretty cool videos. That's it for today, guys. I'm gonna keep enjoying the stroll down Venice Beach, but I'll see you guys real soon. Cheers. THC stands for totally hot chicks. THC stands for tantalizing holistic cure. THC actually stands for therapeutic happy cactus. Good on you, California.